In this lesson, we will look at the different types of livestock digestive systems. Before we look specifically at the types of digestive systems, it's helpful to review the processes of nutrition, which are the same in all species no matter what type of digestive system they have. The six main functions include ingestion, or taking in the food, so how the food is eaten, how it gets into the animal's mouth, mastication or chewing, digestion, which is the breakdown of nutrients, and this is both chemical and physical breakdown, absorption of nutrients into the bloodstream, so how those digested particles are absorbed into the animal's body so that they can then be used by metabolism. And this is just the cellular processes that take place within the body, how those nutrients are used by the animal. And then finally, excretion, or the elimination of waste. In most animals, we will see two products, a liquid and a solid. In poultry, we will see just one. The two major types of digestive systems are the nonruminant, or the simple-stomached or monogastric animals, horses, hogs, and poultry, although we will be considering poultry as a separate type of digestive system because it is rather specialized. And then finally, ruminants. Domestic examples of ruminant animals are cattle, sheep, and goats, and wild animals that you might be familiar with would be deer, moose, and elk. Some general information on nonruminants. They have one stomach compartment, very similar to what humans have. They are very poor users of roughage feedstuffs, and so typically we're going to feed them concentrates or grains. Horses do have a little bit of an adaptation that does allow them to be more efficient users of roughages than most other non-ruminant animals, but as a rule, most non-ruminants are fed concentrates. This is just a picture of a swine digestive system, and if you were to compare this to an example of a human digestive system, you would see a lot of similarities. All the basic parts are there, they're same size, shape, and they will function very similarly to that of a human digestive system. Ruminant digestive systems, some general notes, ruminants tend to eat very rapidly in the scheme of fight versus flight for survival. Ruminants would eat very quickly, find a safe place, and then later bring their food back up to be further digested. That instinct and that adaptation have not been lost. They are very efficient users of roughages, and the primary amount of a ruminant diet is going to be some type of roughage, whether that's hay, silage, haylage, or some other type of fodder. In this picture of a cattle digestive system or a ruminant digestive system, it's very easy to see that there are some major differences. Once the food goes through the esophagus, it goes into this very large compartment. Well, this whole thing is the stomach. And cattle have one stomach, but it does have four compartments. There's the rumen, which is the first part, and you can see through the arrows in the diagram, that's what allows the feed to come back up and be chewed further and then swallowed again. Reticulum, also called the hardware stomach, is where any foreign objects that the animal may have eaten would end up. And then the omasum, and then finally the abomasum, which functions most like what we think a true stomach is functioning like. A couple things on the avian digestive system. The mouth, the esophagus, and the crop, there are a lot of differences. There is a mouth, but it doesn't have lips or teeth. It's been replaced by a beak. It has a tongue and salivary glands, so that's not unusual. The esophagus, or the gullet, is an enlarged area, or has an enlarged area called the crop, and this helps to moisten the feed, and then it also acts as a storage area. And you can see by this diagram where the esophagus is, the crop, and then there really isn't a stomach. There's that wide spot in the below the crop called the proventriculus, functions a lot like a stomach, and then feed passes into the gizzard. And rocks and grit that the animal or the chicken or poultry have eaten help to crush the grain further before it's digested by the rest of the system. We will continue looking at all of the different all the different livestock digestive systems in further detail in class. This is just a brief introduction.